You're done. Once you're a surfer, you're done. You're in.
You're done.
Once you're a surfer, you're done. You're in. You know? It's like the mob or something. You're not getting out.
Humor, more than anything, defines a surfer. Talent's fine, but funny's a lot better. Those that are too serious are treated like Hare Krishnas at the airport. Because after all, why surf if you're not having fun? And by keeping it light, the heavy can be handled.
Everyone is on the same page. We all enjoy the pure fact of riding waves and being in the ocean. No matter how you're doing it, if it's on your stomach, you know, it's just the pure love of the ocean.
Oh yeah, if I'm lying down, I'm gonna be surfing. I'm standing up surfing, halfway standing up, kneeling down, I don't even care. As long as I get in the water and surf, it's gonna go down.
It's about, you know, showing other people of how you can collaborate with somebody else, even though they're in a position the way Jesse's in. He's still willing to, like, hey, you know, you like to surf, you know, just the way if he was walking, let's continue to do this. You know, he's a Pisces, he's a fish. He's supposed to be in the water. So that just tells everybody else, hey, you know, if he's surfing and wow, you know, he might be paralyzed, but hey, that gives me inspiration. Let's go out there and do it. You know, I was always into basketball and, you know, other sports, but surfing now, the way I look at it, is a whole different way. It's more of a spiritual.
I have a lot of burning sensation pain in my body, but once I hit the water, I have no pain whatsoever. If I'm tight, my limbs are like, you know, tight. As soon as I hit the water, get out of the water, everything's loose. I got a smile from ear to ear, and it's like nothing could compare to that.
To be such a top prospect as an amateur, to be just like destined to become a professional surfer, and to have such a tragic accident happen to him.
I broke my neck surfing about 5 years ago. Just pulled into a barrel, and when I was coming out, the wave hit me in my back, and I went head first and didn't have time to put my arms in front of me, and just hit the bottom, and whole body went numb and tingly.
It's so hard for me to think that there's just like that nerve is just, it's broken. It's just one little nerve that's broken right there, and then that's the whole thing that connects. I don't think I do so well, you know?
Jesse called me up because he was having a golf tournament to raise money for his foundation, and he also wanted to talk to me about getting back in the water.
Rob's past, famous surf star, he's like, as a human being that no one really knows about, is just so special. I mean, he's got the biggest heart.
You know, I mean, I was honored, and at the same time, really kind of scared.
I was like, we're going. I'm not nervous. As long as I got you guys, we're fine. But they were all sketched and scared, and there's no need.
It was crazy. The first day we took him surfing was just a complete unknown. We did it.
This was just the beginning. Soon, Jesse and Rob surfed at every opportunity. And with the help of Jesse's brother Josh, his nurse Sonny, and support from old friends like the Malloy brothers, Jesse is back, and he's charging.
For him, nothing's changed. He wants to take off deep. He wants to stay out as long as he can. I asked him, I go, would you rather have it be big and stormy or like this and nice and glassy? And he's all bigger.
And regarding about surfing with Rob, since he's a goofy foot, he's been really biased about me taking off on rights. You're not gonna convert me to a goofy footer just because you are.
Hey, he's a goofy foot too.
Hey, I'm not goofy.
So am I.
You're surrounded by goofy.
I'm the only regular.
Cooties, goofy cooties. Thank you that I have Jesse, and that I have what I have and everything I have. My friends, my family, you know.
Every time he surfs, he calls us up and he's like, hey, Rob took me surfing, man. That guy rules.
If there's anybody who knows about ruling, it's Kelly Slater. the Michael Jordan of surfing. While millions worldwide think of him as a champion, a hero, in his home country of the U.S., he represents one thing, a surfer.
Surfing in the United States is really unfairly stereotyped. I think Fast Times at Ridgemont High and the whole concept of, hey, dude, it really portrayed surfing in a bad way.
I mean, you can turn on SportsCenter on ESPN, and I don't think I've ever seen a surfer on SportsCenter on ESPN, to be honest. Yeah, you turn on, you know, Channel 9 News in Australia, whoever's won the latest tournament in tennis or golf, surfing's right there with it.
In Australia, surfing is like the national pastime. Everybody knows Kelly Slater, and everybody knows the future.
I'm just, you know, I'm hungry for results and hungry for a world title and all the rest of it.
Taj makes his living at the highest level of surfing competition, the World Cup Tour. He's among an elite 44 who battle 9 months in 8 countries for the World Championship. Taj qualified for the World Tour when he was 15 years old. He decided to finish high school instead. He became Rookie of the Year, and the following season was runner-up for the World Championship.
Oh, I think Taj Burrows today is the epitome of modern surfing.
Taj Burrow, to me, is one of the best surfers in the world. To me, he looks like the kind of guy that you draw in your comic book hero, like surfer guy.
It's actually surprised me that Taj hasn't won a world title yet. He's such a talented surfer.
He's the perfect example of that future of pro surfing.
Many think he has the potential to be more than a future champion, but the future of the sport, the next step in surfing's evolution. He's a national hero, but definitely low maintenance. His posse consists of a dog named Reef. Maybe this is normal for an Aussie phenom named after an American blues singer with a one-mutt posse from Yalinga.
This is just perfect because it's really quiet, and the waves are really good, and it's not so crowded, and it's just a lot more relaxing lifestyle than just packing your bags and checking into flights and checking into hotels and stuff like that. So I think it's just the perfect balance.
Taj was born in Australia, but his parents are both Americans. They came here in 1970 looking for waves and never left.
I took him surfing, you know, when he was one or two, just on the nose of my board, and rode a few waves with him like that.
That's really good, yeah.
But he didn't pick it up himself until he was about 7.
My dad tells everybody he taught me to surf. No, my parents both surf, so it was pretty much inevitable I'd end up surfing.
It's kind of disappointing that I wanted to sort of teach him more about surfing, but he picked it up so quickly I didn't get much of the pleasure of passing on my knowledge. It was like, whee!
Taj makes everything look easy, maybe too easy. The best surfer doesn't always win.
Pro Tour has just gotten better and better. They are addressing more of the creative approach to surfing a wave, which is great, because Taj is quite creative.
Creativity is one of the most magical things about surfing, and also one of the most difficult to judge.
It's going to take a long time for us to really catch up to speed with Taj's level. It's going to take a while for the judges to comprehend what he's doing, because he is truly somebody that doesn't really compare to anybody else as far as how many maneuvers he packs in a wave, how innovative he is when he launches airs.
Taj, by any measure, is a great success. At 23, he's already been inducted into Australia's Surfing Hall of Fame. Still, without the world title, he's not satisfied. The expectation of becoming the next Kelly Slater has turned that little monkey on his back into a 500-pound gorilla.
You want to compare Taj and Kelly, there's only one huge difference. Kelly's won 6 world titles and Taj has won none.
To compare great surfers is like comparing artists. Who's to say which one's more aesthetically pleasing? The cut and dry has no place in liquid.
deep, waiting to begin.
There's no standard that gets set like in other sports that you have to meet or else fall behind.
I interviewed Timothy Leary, and his thesis was that the highest destiny of man on earth was to live an aesthetic life based on the dance, and that surfers had discovered this, out there as that was. That helped me realize what it was about surfing that was so worthwhile that it made me feel good about a day that included a go out. The lifestyle.